go find some dark. Hey there, stargazers. I'm Dean Regas, astronomer for the Cincinnati Observatory. Next week, you may be able to see the false dusk of Omar Khayyam, because the moon will be out of the night sky and out of the way.
And I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Pla Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida. We're also going to show you how you can use that out-of-the-way moon to find some planets. Let's get started.
We're facing west after it gets dark next week. You must have a dark sky, free of city lights, to see the false dusk. A good test for your sky is whether you can see the Milky Way. It will start at the horizon in the northwest, pass high overhead, and then drop down and hit the horizon again in the southeast.
If you can't see the Milky Way, assuming it's clear and cloud-free, my suggestion is to get in your car and go find some dark. You may have to drive a good distance, but believe me, it will be worth it.
Many people don't know what a good dark sky looks like because they've never seen one. Most people in the U.S. live in a fairly urbanized, that is, well-lit area. Let's take a quick look at a satellite view of North America at night.
Wow, it's hard to believe that there's that much wasted light being sprayed out into the sky.
Yeah, just think of how many power plants it takes to produce that much wasted light. It isn't doing anybody any good on the ground.
Let's say you can see the Milky Way. Then just take your time and let your eyes get used to the dark. Turn off the flashlights, the headlights, the phone screens, and just soak up some dark. It can take up to an hour for your eyes to get really dark adapted.
And just a brief burst of light can undo all the dark adaptation you've spent so much time trying to achieve.
So, keep it dark.
Facing west, after it gets dark, you may see a rather rare sky phenomenon. Starting at the horizon and extending about halfway up in the sky, look for a faint, rounded pyramid of light. Higher in the west, you should see a fuzzy cluster of stars, the Pleiades. The false dusk doesn't reach as high as the Pleiades, so concentrate your search below the Pleiades.
It's also called the zodiacal light, and what you're seeing is sunlight reflecting off the tiny dust particles that lie in the plane of the orbits of the planets. It is visible every night throughout the year from a really dark location, but in the spring and the fall, it's at its best.
Because then it's straight up from the horizon. During summer and winter, the zodiacal light lies at an angle and doesn't reach so high. Now, a few of you might not want to drive for several hours to find a dark sky.
I can't imagine.
So, let's focus on things we can see from the city.
Like the planets and the moon.
Next week gives us the opportunity to use the moon to help us find a pair of planets after sunset.
Okay, planet number one is Venus. It'll be shining brightly in the west after sunset when you go out to look for the false dusk. In fact, Venus will help in your search because Venus will lie right in the middle of the zodiacal light.
And the red planet Mars lies not far below Venus.
About 10 degrees. And Mars will set about an hour before Venus, so it might not be as easy to find.
But next week, the moon will come to the rescue. On March 21st, look low in the west after sunset for a skinny, two-day-old moon. Then about three fingers to the right of the moon, and bingo, there's Mars.
The following night, March 22nd, a slightly older, fatter, and brighter moon will be just to the left of Venus.
And this will probably be the end of your window to see the zodiacal light, because the light of the moon is enough to overwhelm it.
So, look for the false dusk over the next week or so.
Low in the west, after the sky gets dark, Venus will show you the way as you keep looking up. We'll be right back.